And talk to him on the phone.
I think he's listed in the phone book. I'm not sure.
His wife, I could get a hold of her at least, and then maybe find out if he's.
Yeah.
Okay, stand by. Here we go. Anytime, Bobby.
Well, Brittany, Richard, it's wonderful to be here talking with you about Lassie and various and sundry other things. Brittany, I'll start with you. First of all, I'm so envious of your red hair. In my next life, I want to come back with red hair just like yours. Does everyone tell you that? People talk about your red hair. Let's talk about Lassie. When you would do scenes where Lassie was part of the scene, would Lassie ever goof sometimes?
Usually not. He was a very, very well-trained dog.
And would you feel comfortable going up and playing with Lassie in between shots?
Yeah.
That you didn't have to stay away?
Mm-mm.
Of all the things you did in this movie, what was the most fun for you?
Well, meeting all the nice people and meeting Lassie and seeing how the movie business works.
This is your first movie, isn't it?
Yes.
And but what had you done before this?
I did a soap opera called All My Children.
And obviously you were a child, but what kind of a child were you in that?
Well, what do you mean?
I mean, were you just a normal kid, or did you have problems, or?
I was a normal kid.
Okay, and how old were you when you did that?
I was eight.
And how old are you now?
Eight.
Oh, all right, so that was recent then. Was that the first professional thing you ever did?
No.
What was the first thing?
I think, I'm not sure. I can't remember real good, but I think it's a commercial. I can't say.
But anyway, it was a commercial, and you got paid. That's the important thing. Richard, let's get you in the conversation here, because you and I have known one another a long time, and I know that you're a rancher in New Mexico. That's where you hang out in between gigs, as they say. But I know you also started your career as a stuntman. Is that not right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, when you look at the stuntmen today and the things they have to do, Richard, how does that compare with the things that you did when you were a young stuntman?
Well, I never did anything as wild as these kids are doing. My son's a stuntman, and he blows those cars up, and I just did horse work. They were regular routine stunts, but they're really coming up with some fantastic stunts now. I can't hardly look at them, much less try to do them, but it's really changed that way. And the techniques and the special effects are 10 times better than they were when I was doing them.
Do you think the stunt people are at more risk today than in your day?
I really don't, because although it looks really wild, they get a chance to rig it, and they're pretty well. We'd hit the ground so much, and one thing has to happen. If you leave a horse or wagon, you have to hit the ground. That's inevitable. How you hit it depends on how long you can survive in the business. But the way these kids are doing, this stuff is pretty well planned out, much more than ours was. It's a lot different, and they're making a lot more money, which is great.
Richard, were you around when they were shooting the water scenes in this movie?
I never was involved in those. I'd stay in town because I didn't have anything to do, but I saw the picture last night.
What did you think about that?
Oh, it's incredible. The waterfall and the fast current. I thought it was great.
Did it surprise you that the dog would be in the water and the kids themselves?
Well, no, not really. I had an idea that they were going to have to do it for the movie. But I didn't know it would be as spectacular as it was when I saw it last night.
What do you consider, Richard, the most dangerous stunt you ever had to do?
Well, rather than be repetition, just trying to get paid for it. Of course, that's a joke. But I think working on trains with horses, I've come awful close to going under a train, which is the end, you know. I think so, but I've been real lucky. I've been skinned up a little bit.
No broken bones?
No, not really.
Really?
Just pulled tendons. Sometimes that's worse than a break. I've had things that took me quite a while to come out of. No, I was very fortunate.
Well, you look great.
Thank you.
And congratulations to all of you on the success of Lassie. I hope
Thank
it does
you.
Well. And I look forward to seeing both of you again sometime. Maybe a sequel for Lassie, okay? All right.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.
Hold him and talk to him on the phone.
I think he's listed in the phone book. I'm mm-hmm. not sure.
His wife, I could get a hold of her at least, and then maybe find out if he's.
Yeah.
Okay, stand by. Here we go. Anytime, Bobby.
Well, Brittany, Richard, it's wonderful to be here talking with you about Lassie and various and sundry other things. Brittany, I'll start with you. First of all, I'm so envious of your red hair. In my next life, I want to come back with red hair just like yours. Does everyone tell you that? People talk about your red hair. Let's talk about Lassie. When you would do scenes where Lassie was part of the scene, would Lassie ever goof sometimes?
Usually not. He was a very, very well-trained dog.
And would you feel comfortable going up and playing with Lassie in between shots?
Yeah.
That you didn't have to stay away?
Mm-mm.
Of all the things you did in this movie, what was the most fun for you?
Well, meeting all the nice people and meeting Lassie and seeing how the movie business works.
This is your first movie, isn't it?
Yes.
And but what had you done before this?
I did a soap opera called All My Children.
And obviously you were a child, but what kind of a child were you in that?
Well, what do you mean?
I mean, were you just a normal kid, or did you have problems, or?
I was a normal kid.
Okay, and how old were you when you did that?
I was 8.
And how old are you now?
8.
Oh, all right, so that was recent then. Was that the first professional thing you ever did?
No.
What was the first thing?
I think, I'm not sure. I can't remember real good, but I think it's a commercial. I can't say.
But anyway, it was a commercial, and you got paid. That's the important thing. Richard, let's get you in the conversation here, because you and I have known one another a long time, and I know that you're a rancher in New Mexico. That's where you hang out in between gigs, as they say. But I know you also started your career as a stuntman, is that not right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, when you look at the stuntmen today and the things they have to do, Richard, how does that compare with the things that you did when you were a young stuntman?
Well, I never did anything as wild as these kids are doing. My son's a stuntman, and he blows those cars up, and I just did horse work. They were regular routine stunts, but they're really coming up with some fantastic stunts now. I can't hardly look at them, much less try to do them, but it's really changed that way. And the techniques and the special effects are 10 times better than they were when I was doing them.
Do you think the stunt people are at more risk today than in your day?
I really don't, because although it looks really wild, they get a chance to rig it, and they're pretty well. We'd hit the ground so much, and one thing has to happen. If you leave a horse or wagon, you have to hit the ground. That's inevitable. How you hit it depends on how long you can survive in the business. But the way these kids are doing, this stuff is pretty well planned out, much more than ours was. It's a lot different, and they're making a lot more money, which is great.
Richard, were you around when they were shooting the water scenes in this movie?
I never was involved in those. I'd stay in town because I didn't have anything to do, but I saw the picture last night.
What did you think about that?
Oh, it's incredible. The waterfall and the fast current. I thought it was great.
Did it surprise you that the dog would be in the water and the kids themselves?
Well, no, not really. I had an idea that they were going to have to do it for the movie. But I didn't know it would be as spectacular as it was when I saw it last night.
What do you consider, Richard, the most dangerous stunt you ever had to do?
Well, rather than be repetition, just trying to get paid for it. Of course, that's a joke. But I think working on trains with horses, I've come awful close to going under a train, which is the end, you know. I think so, but I've been real lucky. I've been skinned up a little bit.
No broken bones?
No, not really.
Really?
Just pulled tendons. Sometimes that's worse than a break. I've had things that took me quite a while to come out of. No, I was very fortunate.
Well, you look great.
Thank you.
And congratulations to all of you on the success of Lassie. I hope
Thank
it does
you.
Well. And I look forward to seeing both of you again sometime. Maybe a sequel for Lassie, okay? All right.
Thank you.
Bye. Thank you.